responden. Kira. 1, 2, 3.
Okay, hi guys. Today I need to present you about ATM machine for object-oriented programming project. So here, firstly, I would like to introduce the three tier of the design of this ATM machine, which is the first tier is presentation layer, and then the second tier is business logic, and also the third tier is database. And presentation layer, we have we do have here login page, option form, withdraw form, show balance form, and receipt form. For business logic, we have login page .java, option form, withdraw form, show balance, receipt form, check balance, update account, and also display balance. And the third tier is database. We have connection SQL.java. And here is the programming layer, which is I show you the login form. This is the GUI for front end of the coding. Here you can see the user need to prompt 5 number, and we have 3 functional button, which is withdraw, check balance, and quit. And if the user choose to enter withdraw, just you need to enter the amount, and also you need to select the radio button of denomination, which is 10 ringgit, 20, and also 50. And if the user used to check balance form, here it is. The with prompt account number, withdrawal amount, and also the balance that only left. Okay, here's is the business tier, which part that we are connecting to database. Here is the part of we connecting the database, and this is a table name for account and login for the database. And here we entering the object oriented concept. First encapsulation, which is public void set balance amount, and also public integer get balance amount. So as we know, encapsulation is one of the fundamental of the OOP. It refers to bundling of data with the method that operate on that data. And we have polymorphism. Here it is. Private integer login and also public login. So here is generally the ability to appear in many forms. That's why it's as public. And then we have inheritance, which is it has extend and also implement. As we know that inheritance in object-oriented programming enables new object to take on the properties of existing object. And in this project, all class inherit class JFrame to reuse component and method inside the JFrame class. It also implement connection interface to use method related to the connection to the database. Okay, so the conclusion is this application has been developed using object-oriented concept and linking with the database. And the code developed using 3-tier architecture, which is presentation tier, business tier, and also database tier. And it provides an ease of maintenance of the code, managing the presentation code and also business logic separately, so that a change to business logic. Alright, I think that's all from me. Thank you.